a live interview with John Presko about the ministry days at Thayer Christian Church. So you left the Howard's house.
Yeah, we left and we went up and we met with the elders mm-hmm. of the church. Mm-hmm. And this was a small town. Now we came from Long Beach.
Long Beach, California.
400,000.
Yeah.
To a little town of 400. Mm-hmm. Now it's interesting when you come into the town from the south and you're heading north. The sign out front, since it was the watermelon capital of Kansas, it said on their welcome to Thayer, Kansas, watermelon capital of Kansas. 400 friendly people. But if you come in from the north, going south, the
right.
sign said 500 friendly people.
Right.
So I asked the mayor, who was an elder in the church there, and I said, why didn't they change that? He said, well, we just haven't got around to it yet. They were a little slow.
Maybe the other side had more cows than they were counting the cows out there.
Well, I don't know. But so anyway, we met with them, and Mom stayed out in the car. We had a Volkswagen bus. And she stayed out in the car in front of the church while I was meeting with the elders at the church. Well, they had a guy lined up to preach that Sunday. Mm-hmm. So they wanted to know if I could stay and preach the following Sunday.
Yeah.
Well, Mom had to get back to work. She only had that week, and here it was on Tuesday night. And it turns out that it was decided to have a switch that I would preach the coming Sunday and that other guy the next Sunday after that.
Now, did you have an interview when they decided that? I mean, that would have been a pretty good impression for them to do that.
Yeah, it was that Tuesday night.
Okay, yeah. Well, great. Yeah. And who was those interviews with from Thayer, do you remember?
Oh, the elders, Leo and Bernie Barger and Floyd Powers. And
was David Thornton in there?
Or? He was a deacon.
He was still young, mm-hmm.
yeah.
Well, he's
Charlie Doherty was an elder. Raymond McKenzie was an elder. They had eight elders at the time.
So what did you think? What was your first impression of Thayer when you were there? Outside of the city.
I was just anxious to get to church.
Right.
And so they were fine. It was a good church around about 160.
And that's the old Thayer building on Main Street?
Yeah, Main Street.
Right. Uh-huh. Oh, yeah. Here's a picture. I forgot.
Uh-huh. And the parsonage was next to the
church.
The church was on the right side, and then the parsonage, and then the funeral home.
Right, and this says 1967 to 70, so were you there 3 years for that
term?
Three and a half years, okay, so.
Yeah, and I used to kid people saying, since the church is on the right and the funeral home is on the left, that I would marry him on the right and bury him on the left.
Well, what was it you used to say when we were little? You'd say, well, I'm going to go marry the living and bury the dead.
Yeah, I'll try.
That's great. So, you were in the parsonage. Now, what was that like? Was it a nice house?
Yeah, it was on the main street, and it was nice. And they had quite a custom there in that town in the summertime, from like Memorial Day, the end of May, through the picnic, the yearly picnic coming to town, which was usually Labor Day weekend, they had something uptown called the Amateur Hour. And so every Saturday night, it would kick in around 7:30 or so, the cars would come in and the main street, and they'd back in, either side of the street, they'd back in, and then they had a grandstand, which was a flatbed trailer, and they had some of the old guys that played by ear, the guitars and banjo and whatever. And when they got done, or if a soloist came, or whatever, different ones, they would, instead of clapping, they all would honk their horns. And so I talked to Harry, the funeral director, and I said, Harry, what are you going to do on Saturday night when you have visitation? And everybody's out there honking the horns. And he said, oh, we manage. But anyway.
Now, back then, Dad, wasn't that the funeral director that you told us that would call you up to come with him?
Yeah, a lot of times he would call me. He'd get real nervous. And he'd call me, and he had an ambulance service, too, a blue station wagon with a light he put on, the red light.
Like the old-fashioned kind,
Mayberry.
Like Mayberry.
And so one of those nights in the summer, we were over at his house playing checkers. And this fellow from across the street walks over and he said, Harry, I think I'm having a heart attack. You take me to the hospital. And that was in Chanute, 15 miles north. So we got him in and he rode in the back of the station wagon, flat, what do you call them?
The stretcher.
And so we got up there, we got through Earlton, and then we're up. And he said, Harry, there's something wrong. This oxygen tank, I'm not getting any air. Well, it turns out Harry forgot to fill it.
Oh no. He
didn't have any air, and he got up to the hospital and he said he was going to make it. Right. So we come back, we go through Earlton, and the police is behind Harry with the red light on. And they stopped him for speeding, and he told me, don't tell Virginia, that's his wife, that he got this ticket.
Even though he had one of those vehicles, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But he was speeding. But anyway, we had a lot of incidents picking up bodies. And
wow. Yeah. So did you do a lot of funerals for him?
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Would you say you did more for him than any other place? Or?
Well, yeah, because that was the only funeral home in town.
Right, right.
So.
Right, so how many churches were in Thayer, do you remember?
Three. Seventh-day Adventists, and they ran around 20. And the Methodist Church, and they ran around 40 or 50. And then we were 160. But when we left 3.5 years later, we were running around 230, 240.
Yeah. So, talk about, now, that wasn't when you guys built the church, was it? The first term?
No, they were. We met with the Goodman Church Builders in Joplin were going to vote, and our men decided because of the cost that they didn't want to do it. So we went ahead and left on good terms, and 11 years later, in 1981, they called us back. We were in Illinois at the time, and Tom Whitten, Albert James, the three of them, and they all called me, not knowing the other one had called. And they said, John, would you come back and help us build a building? Well, that was the reason we left the first time, because they didn't want to. But 11 years later, and of course the cost is a lot more in 11 years, and we went ahead and came back and started our second ministry at that church. And we were there 7.5 more years.
Right.
So we were there all together 11 years.
Right. Now, something really special and awesome happened during your first term there at Thayer in 1970. What was a big highlight that happened then?
Well, in 1970, Mom and I wanted to adopt. And so we went through the Kansas Children's Service League in Wichita. And it worked out that John Williams was placed in our home.
Yeah.
And back then you had a choice if you wanted a boy or a girl.
Mm-hmm.
And we wanted a boy, and so they tried to match you up.
Right. So what was that like? Did you get, where did you guys drive to pick him up at?
Wichita.
Wichita.
Yeah, he was born at St. Joseph Hospital in Wichita.
And how many days was he?
He was 21 days old when we got him.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So he was at the hospital when you picked him up?
He was at the office of the Kansas Children's Service League.
Oh, okay. Okay. So J.W., who's John, was born March 23rd. 1970. Do you remember the date you picked him up?
I think it was a Wednesday.
Yeah.
I'm not sure.
So it would have been April if he was 21.
Yeah,
something like that. So then, what was that like? Talk about that.
Well, he cried. And, but we had a group at our church called the Psalmettes. They were ladies' trio. Well, actually a quartet and a pianist. And we were scheduled to be in Nebraska Christian College in Norfolk for their annual convention. And they were going to bring the special music, and I was going to be one of the featured speakers at night. And then I led a seminar in the day in the youth program in the church, because we had a real strong youth program.
Right.
And so we went up there, and Mom was left there. So Gladys James came over and stayed with her and helped her get through that. So it's just an adjustment to get used to.
Yeah.
But it worked out good.
He was a cute baby.
Yeah.
Yeah, he was a real cute little guy. So that's your first term in Thayer.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, we were very happy. It was a good situation.
Yeah, okay.
Stay tuned for more stories about Thayer, Kansas, and much, much more. And Then Some, the live documentary releasing June 11th, 2014.